What doing there? Come on here. Why you are not ready? Bring that.
No, I'm not playing. Ramana Subbu wants to play. We can do tomorrow. Okay. Playing.
You cancel.
No, you do it.
I cancel.
No, you do it.
I'm not canceling. I'm not playing guitar. Ramana Subbu is playing guitar. I'm speaking.
Tata should speak and he should play in guitar.
Afterwards.
No, no, just move.
Just
now,
just now. Yes, sir. Yesterday.
Give me some microphone.
Who's playing?
Microphone?
You want to come up here?
Right? You should come here, further.
Ramana.
Come closer, come closer, Ramana.
Ramana's playing?
Oh, get that harmonium and give here. Don't change anything. Thank you. Sit together. Page 178.
Page 178 in your
phone book. Quickly. Why you been there? You have to pay something. For. Okay. If any place you can go here.
Jana Mana Sita Tari.
Thank you.
No, no, you should speak, but...
I will, I'm just going to take this and move it.
Shri Gurudev ki jai, Shri Gurudev ki jai, Go Prahante. Everybody's telling me once upon a time, so we'll begin once upon a time. In a village that will remain unnamed, there was a little boy who grew up slowly, slowly. And as he grew up, he was the most charming boy in his village. As he wandered here and there playing with his friends, he, in a young age, did not distinguish between male and female. But as he grew up, he began to distinguish this. Just one moment, Greg Malcolm was trying to have a word with me. As he grew up, he began to tell the difference. And wandering with his friends here and there, he saw the most beautiful girl in the village. And something happened to him. Something happened to him that he could not quite understand. That is, that when he left that village, he felt separation. And he was drawn inextricably to this village over and over again to see this beautiful girl. He could not understand how his heart was being transformed. Why he cried when he did not see her. Why he longed to be with her. He did not notice. One day he approached a sagacious woman of the village, an aged woman in charge of those of that village and the pastimes in that village. And he expressed his heart to that elderly woman. And she said, "My dear sweet boy, it sounds like you're in love." He said, "Love?" He said, "Maya, what's love?" And she said, "Love is something that you feel, a connection that you feel deeply with another person. That being separated from them gives you great dissatisfaction and unhappiness. But being connected with them and seeing them and being with them, thinking of them, gives you great joy. So much joy, in fact, that you long to be united with that person." So having given her definition of love, the boy then understood what he was feeling. It was only after the definition was given of love. The word love was given first. "What do I feel, Maya? What do I feel, Mother?" She said, "You feel something called love." "Well, what is love? What is that love? Define that love." So she defined love. And in the definition of love, he found himself, this young boy. And he began to play with his friends. And his friends noticed a change in him. "What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you?" He says, "I think I'm in love." "Well, what's love? What's love?" So he gave the same definition to them. And then when they heard that definition of love, they too understood what love was. But until the definition and the word were given, they did not understand what they were feeling or how to express that to others. Yesterday, Srila Gurudev gave four definitions, and he also gave two aspects of that love. The first was the definition of love. Anyabhilashatashunyam jnana paramadhinavratam anukulyam krishnamushilanam bhaktirutamam. That is, that the unbroken cultivation of affection to Sri Krishna with all endeavors of the body, mind, words, and spiritual sentiments, which is not covered by knowledge aimed at impersonal liberation or selfish, materially motivated activities, and whose only focus is to give pleasure to Sri Krishna and which is beneficial for our Krishna consciousness. This is called love. So this is the definition he gave. Brothers and sisters, we've been rotating in the material world for many, many millions of lives, searching for what is called love, but not knowing how to describe it, not knowing the word, and not knowing the definition. In Prayag, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met with Srila Rupa Goswami, and he gave him what is called, like, a bhakti rasamrita sindhu. He gave him a bindu. He gave him a drop of the ocean of love of Krishna. Having given Srila Rupa Goswami a drop, Srila Rupa Goswami was sent to Sri Vrindavan Dham, where he took that drop and scrutinizingly analyzed it through what? Through the microscope, through the telescope, through his technical understanding, through Sri Haridam, and through serving Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. These were the instruments through which he analyzed this drop of love that was given in Prayag by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Having analyzed this drop, he felt competent and given great
love by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Great Benediction, he took that drop and manifested the ocean once again. The ocean is called Sri Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. That means the ocean of pure love for Sri Krishna and pure affection. So Srila Gurudev has done something very, very beautiful. He has taken these definitions that have been stored away, and he is now traveling the world and giving all of this. What am I feeling in my heart, Gurudev? What am I feeling? What have I been searching for life after life after life? So he says, love, which is prem. But this prem has been misplaced. The sun of prem, the sun of love, Srimati Radhika, is shining throughout every particle, everything in every particle of the universe. But when that love is transformed and transmuted through our bodies, through our intelligence, through our minds, it becomes transposed into something called lust. It becomes very, very limited in its scope. And instead of loving the Atma of another human being, we're forced to love the most superficial aspect of another person. Just imagine, we can all understand the analogy of a woman who has lots of money. And a man, he has a relationship with that woman and gets married for her money, for something that's totally different from herself. We all understand what a gold digger is. That's what a gold digger is. He actually had a relationship with that person for something external, superficial. That is, for wealth. And having gained her wealth, he'll do anything. He'll kill her, he'll do anything. Because that's his, now his. This is the equivalent of loving body, of loving the external aspect of who we are, the superficial aspect of who we are. This definition of love says that all love must be reposed back into the source of love, which is Radha Krishna. So that's the first definition. It must be uncovered by our own actions and also by our knowledge that we have. The second definition he gave was sadhana. Kriti sadhya, vagat sadhya, bhava sa sadhanavita, nitya siddhasya bhavasya, prakatyam kriti sadhya.
Thank you. Good experience. Good. Thank you. Adhyanatimirandasya. ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे वञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाभुजन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो यस्टर्डे explain about the goal of life. Krishna is not goal of life. He is only sambandh, relation. We should have a relation with Krishna. To serve Krishna is avidheya. What is this? Avidheya?
Process means.
But actually our goal is Krishna prem. Krishna prem. Prem, my seva, service to Krishna. Krishna is supreme law. Very beautiful, very beautiful. More than thousands of moons of moons. There is no word in universe to speak or to give any
description.
He is so much qualified, merciful, unlimited for all qualities are. Even so many qualities who are some opposites, all are in Krishna. You know that Krishna is Lord of Lords, Ramchandra, Narayan and all other are lords. They have 60 qualities in four. These qualities are full in Bhagavat Tattva. But more four qualities, Rupa Madhuri. Rupa Madhuri means? Rupa Madhuri, Leela Madhuri, sweet past tense. Any of the manifestation of Krishna, even Ramchandra, Narayan, Nrisimha, or they cannot play roles with so many gopis. They cannot. Even Dwarkadhish Krishna, he cannot do. He cannot do. Like Krishna. So, Rupa Madhuri, Leela Madhuri, Venu Madhuri, all can fight with and Krishna, oh, he will take animal heart by throat. Very sweet. And Parikar Madhuri. His all associates are so sweet. So, Krishna is supreme. So his prem toward the prem of anyone towards Krishna is Priyojan. We see Arjuna. He has so much of love and affection that Krishna accepted his service to serve Arjuna. All are serving Krishna, Ram, Nrisimha. But Krishna is so sweet that he wants to serve his devotee. And he has promised, ananyaschintayanto mange jana padyupasati teshamam nitya abhijuktana yogachemam vaham. What is the meaning? Pundarik is here, or he will sit in the house. Why? You should explain.
In this verse in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna is stating that those who are exclusively devoted to me, ananyaschintayantumam, that for them, whatever they are lacking, I provide. And whatever they already have, then I maintain that.
Not good explanation. Something like ananyaschintayanto. They are only engaged. They have engaged their whole senses. More like Uttama Bhakti. And they don't think about his maintenance, their maintenance. nothing. There are none other than Krishna. One is having Krishna Vishnu and not anything to maintain his body. There are no time at all to think all these things. No desire at all, except to serve Krishna. And if they have no time to maintain themselves, then I go there to them and see what they need, how to maintain them. I anyhow discover, and then, I maintain themselves, taking the things, objects, on my way, carry, on my shoulders, and then go. Personally, I go. Not by anyone other. So here Arjuna has no time to look after him, look after his wife and children. You know, Krishna, what did he? He is training the archery to Abhimanyu Dishan of Arjuna. What is he doing? His chariot. And Arjuna gives order. And he follows the order. Arjuna told, as you should take my chariot in the midst of the boats. And what Arjuna is telling, even horses are now tired. And then what did? He gave water to, and he was messaging horses, not Arjuna, to tell Arjuna. He was messaging his horses and make fresh. So even if there was dog, Krishna can suck that dog of Arjuna, if really. You know? He could not repay Arjuna. Hanuman was serving. And Ram was pleased, but not so much pleased. He was not controlled. And by Hanuman, by Arjuna, he was so much pleased. He became charioteer. He washed his horses, made them fresh. Also, he went to Shankar Mahadev, told that you will have to help Arjuna because you will have to fight a big war and he should own the race. So you should give all archery, all qualities, all astra-shastra,
all weapons
to. And he did. And he did order to Hanuman, you should always be with me on the chariots.
Right.
And he was there. And he told not only to be. So he has no desire for wealth and reputation, position or anything. He can, but anyhow, he was married with a very high class of chaste, beautiful lady. Who was she? Daughter of Gacharya or Mathura. He married her daughter to this Sudama Mitra. So she was very beautiful, young lady, and very chaste, and he was Pativrata, chaste lady. But you know that he never wanted any earth. He has nothing to do for money, no material. So he used to do bhajan daily, only bhajan and bhajan. But he will have to maintain his wife.
How he can? Sometimes he used to bake something, but totally he was. Ananashyantayanto, mange jana parjushkas. Tesham ham nitya jubi abhijuktanam jok chen. So, he never used to go to bake something to others. Anyhow, very easily what comes, used to come. And he was satisfied like that. So in very short time, they became old. His wife became old, lean and thin, skeletal was there, like her husband. She was very worried to maintain his wife, his husband, because he had no chesta. No desire. So he was always used to chant and remember Krishna, reading books. So he had no time at all to do all these things. So his wife was so worried. How to maintain my husband? If something begging coming easily, she used to cook very small quantity. And he used to offer to his husband. And he, knowing that it is very small, he used to take only half or less than half himself, and he used to keep for her, his wife. So becoming more and more weaker and weaker and old. Now her breast became dry. His stomach went on back. She became old. He was very worried to maintain his husband. But he was always engaged in bhajan sadhana. One day she came. She was also very qualified, the son, the daughter of Gargacharya, you know how he was famous. Astrologer, best astrologer in world, whole world at that time. So she came and trembling like kaapti hui, trembling. And somewhat very polite, she told the Prabhu, I know that you have no desire any worldly things. Always you are engaged in sadhana bhajan. How to maintain this family? Now you are family person. So you should look after. Otherwise we will die. So I want that. I know that Sri Hari, the king of Dwarka, he has so much affluences. And he is Brahmanya Dev. Very, very much honor for Brahmins. And he was not only Brahmin, Brahmin and also friend of Dwarkadhish. I want you should go there. Don't beg anything from him. He will see and automatically he will give you everything. And she requested again and again. So he was now thinking that, what should I do? I should go to Dwarka and beg something for my maintenance. Oh, that I cannot do. But she is requesting again and again. So I must go there and the fruit will be there. What? Or take the darshan of, oh, not Dwarkadhish only. The Supreme Lord. Anyhow, this will be my fortune. So I must go. But I will never beg anything. No money, no sampat, no earth, nothing. He decided. And then told that, Arya. As this is Indian. Actress. Arya. Oh. Arya. You should give me something, presentation that I may give him. Because it is a rule, regulation, process that way. If anyone goes to any friend, he should take something, presentation. So, I want some. Can you give me? Oh, she saw that nothing was there in his house. Nothing, totally nothing. No mice, even there. Where mice?
There is no rice.
Oh, no rice. So, she went to others, neighbors, and she baked something. Broken rice in pieces. Like who the Indian is, who? Broken rice. You are so rich you don't know what is broken. But we know. So, and she binded it in any dirty cloth, piece of. And he took and he went to Dwarka. From morning he was walking, and in the evening he reached there. Oh, by the help of a stick. When he reached Dwarka, where to go? Oh, each queens of Krishna, 16,108 queens, good palaces. Where to go? Where now Krishna? How he can search? So he went first, Padhi, Deodi, second, third, fourth. Deodi means?
Door.
In king's castle, so many palaces. So he crossed first, second, third. But now he was thinking where to go. Then he asked anyone, he told, you must go to Rukmini house, Rukmini palace. He may be there. And they took him. When he went to the door, far, far away, Krishna was in the palace of Rukmini. He saw. And at once ran, weeping and embraced. There was so much in his feet.
Cracks.
Also dirty was there. Cloth not well dressed. Because he is poor. Knowing it was poor. But he was the richest person. Why? He had no desire. Those who are like the President of America, what? Bush. Bush is most poor person. Most. Why? He has so many desires. So many desires. Also, before him, Clinton, a most poorest person. Myself, a richest person. Maharaja. Worldly desire. My desire is transcendental. Anyone can give, cannot give in this world. My Gurudev and our Guru Asat or Guru Parampara, they can give. So, but he was externally poor, looks like poor, but he was not poor because he had no desire at all. I request you all that you don't have any worldly desire. Other will be cheated. Don't have any desire. Only desire to serve Krishna. By this you can be happy, otherwise no. So he has no desire. So Krishna embraced him and took him to the palace of Rukmini. And as an elder brother, he requested, he honored so much. And he told that you should sit here, and took him and seated. Now, this poor Brahmin, dirty clothes and so on, and he sat on the palanquin of a Rukmini. Not from Palani, Veda. And Krishna, weeping, brought water pot and water. Oh, very fragrant. And with tear mixing, he washed the feet of that Brahmin. The queens came there and saw that what doing this Krishna. What relation? And he is washing Krishna feet. They began to with chamar off. And they were looking very ashcharyachakit hokar dekh rahe. After washing, and Krishna gave tambul vitika. Tambul vitika, you know, better way. And he gets so many things. And very delicious preparations he offered. And with love and affection he was, oh, more this chutney, this malpua, kheer, and so many things he was giving. After that he messaged his feet, talking so many things. Now this Brahmin has some doubt whether he recognizing me that I am that very poor Sudama studying in the Gurukul or not. So Krishna knew this, his doubt, and began to tell, oh my dear Sakha, you remember that one day when it was a rainy day and also very cold day, there was no dry wood for cooking. So Godmother said that you should bring, and we went in the forest, and oh, it began to rain very heavily. We collected some wood, but it was so much rain that everywhere water and water, ocean of water, flooded so much that we could not decide that where, how much water is. So whole night we passed taking the heap of bundle of sticks on head, both, oh, trembling, so cold. When morning came, sun came, oh Gurudev came, sun deepening. Oh my dear sons, where Krishna and Sudama, where you are. And they told that, oh we are here, why you are here? And then he came near and he was weeping and told that, oh, I am very much satisfied. A disciple should serve Gurudev like this. Any disciple should serve his Gurudev like this. You have served me, I am now satisfied. All learning of Veda, archery and 64 kinds of arts, all should come in your heart and you should be perfect. And he did like so, and happy thinking, automatically. You remember? Oh, I remember. Oh, then a doubt went. Whole night talking, and it became morning. Oh, Sudama told that, oh, my grihini is waiting for me. Now I should. I'm very happy to meet you. You remember everything. So I want to return back to my home. Krishna told that, oh, very good. He gave nothing. Oh, one thing. I forget. And before taking prasad, he told to Sudama, my dear Sakha, I know that my sister-in-law, Bhabhi, has sent something for me, and you have brought, but why you are not giving? Gita shloka. Patram pushpam phalam toyam je me bhaktya prayachati prajata. Who has love and affection for me? Even flowers, even leaves, anything he gives, patram pushpam phalam toyam, even water he gives with love and affection. I very happily, with satisfied, I take it. But I don't take those who have false ego, like Duryodhana and others. And I quarrel, and possibly I take from devotees, like Mahaprabhu took from Sridhar Kolaraj. So he told, so I like you this presentation. And forcibly he took from here, he had one handful he took, and when second he was going to take, oh, Rukmini Saptabhama, they stop. Don't take, Prabhu. What will you give? You have given everything. Now you want to give us to by this. So you should not take. And he was, Sudama was seeing. But he never gave anything. After that, they slept. And in morning he told that, I want to go return back. He came with Brahmin, up to the border, he followed. And he gave nothing, a single paisa for him. But he was thinking, oh, my Prabhu is so merciful that he never gave me a farthing to me. Other I will have so many false errors. So he is very kind to me. And thus thinking, he came to his house in the evening. And he was searching his house. Where is my house? Oh, my house was here. But here, oh, 16,008 royal palaces are there. And so many Biman means airplanes are here, very glittering of gold and diamonds. And so many, I have had one cow, like old. And now I'm saying Kamdhenu. So many. Also I see elephants, horses, and all everything. Why it came? Why? Each queens of Krishna gave one. So one elephant, so many elephants. So many horses, so many cows, so many chariots, so many aeroplanes and so many. And cows come then. What became of his wife? A wife became very teenager. teenager. Very beautiful, most beautiful. And thousands of maidservants being expert in everything. And now she became old. So who was now old, now she became. How is it become? Krishna gives, if anyone wants a little. Je jathang mam, but he gave much more than he wanted. He never wanted this. But he gave. But, so he was now thinking, what he became after that? He was weeping. Oh Krishna, I will forget you. So he had no taste for all these things. As he was before, he was without entangled in all these things. And he was doing bhajan like before. When he came there, his wife with so many sakhis, dasis, maidservants, singing, well decorated, very kishori. She came with a pot to Arati. And he was saying, who are they? His wife recognized him because he was in the same shape, form. But he could not because form was changed. Now she was so beautiful. So, when they were coming nearby and he was going by. Why they are coming to me? Because he could not recognize. And after that she embraced him and did arati. Then he knew. She told that, oh, I'm your same wife. Oh, now when she embraced and he became also teenage. Then he was weeping bitterly that, oh Krishna, how you did? How you did? Miracle. You gave so much. How I'll digest? I will forget your bhakti. But anyhow, he never forget. He was like same as before. I told that, je jathang mam prapadante, Krishna gave so much. But, you know, Krishna sent some ornaments through Nanda Baba to Yashoda mother. And what became? Oh, always reminding Krishna, and she used to weep bitterly. Oh, Krishna cheated me, cheated us. He has sent ornaments. By ornaments, oh, Vasudeva and Devaki have purchased Krishna. And thus weeping always. So these ornaments and wealth cannot satisfy any bhakta of Krishna. He cannot give anything in to repay gopis. Gopi Ranga. You know one lady of Mathura, Kubja. She was very attached to Krishna when she saw. Krishna took his what? Chandan. And for this what he gave? Oh, she became very young. Oh, she took like this and she became very beautiful. But she wanted to enjoy with Krishna. For a moment Krishna fulfilled his desire. And that is why she came in like Naika. What kind of sadharani Naika? He became. Not like Gopi Samartha. Eh? Oh, if anyone wants to serve Krishna, but desire to enjoy himself, then that devotee is not qualified. Any Gopi? They have no worldly desire or anything from Krishna. And Krishna cannot repay them. But for Kuvya, oh, she wanted something for herself. So she is not qualified like gopis, even not like queens. We should know that object. These prems, even Sudama prem is not perfect. It is not our object, because Krishna gave him so much thing. But gopis cannot take. So we should know. Our object should be what? Prem prayojan, but prem like gopis. So having this object, we should try to follow the process. From tomorrow, we will explain the process. Adau Shraddha, Sadhu Sangha, Bhajana Kriya, Anartha Nivritti, and thus. From tomorrow, from bhajan rahasya. Go Premani. क्या कर रही
है? ये कपड़े धोने में कोई पैसा खर्च नहीं होता है, तो सुदामा की पत्नी ने ऐसे कपड़े के सवाल क्यों भेजे, कपड़े को धो के साफ करवाएंगे?
ना, साफ तो होंगे, किंतु पुराने कपड़े क्या साफ होंगे? He has no price to, and he has no desire to bring new cloth or anything, and he could not, because he has no effort for this. So not you think that, oh, dirty so much. But anyhow, they are old and old and old.
Hare Krishna. So some devotee has requested again for initiation. So initiation will be tomorrow again, 8:30 a.m. in Gurudev Bhajan Kuti, room number 242. And whoever wants initiation, please register your name with Jagmohan Prabhu.